I'm very honored to be here and have this opportunity to speak about spaghetti. Sorry, but it's important to know that for our company, that maybe some of you know, Barilla is the number one manufacturer of pasta in the world, but we are quite nothing here in China. And China is the country that invented spaghetti. So you may remember Marco Polo in the oldest centuries, in the 13th century, went here. He was an Italian from Venice, merchant, and he discovered a lot of very beautiful things that he was the first to report back to the Western world. Among those was noodles. And noodles came in Italy and became spaghetti, fettuccine, fusilli, because we changed only the ingredients, raw material that we have a lot of durum wheat. So pasta is made by semolina and aqua and water. So that's the point we made with creativity different forms. So for me, it's really an opportunity to be here back at talking about Barilla, about pasta, in order to rebuild this way back of spaghetti back to China. And hopefully present to you some of the competence that we have developed through the centuries and doing spaghetti. And hopefully start with the business here. We have a couple of offices here in China and start to have business, really business with you guys. So my presentation, given that, will be committing in, first of all, present Barilla. So I would use a video that is better than a lot of words. And say how much in our company is important in terms of effectiveness, two main tasks. One is sell, another one is make great products. You will discover that Barilla is not only pasta, but is a lot of complexity product and categories. And as go through the integrated planning, that is my key accountability, that is really the key to deliver best in supply chain. And last but not really least is customer collaboration. Previous speech has already underlined how important it is to fill the gap sometimes in communication and collaboration that we have around the chain. What we call our supply chain is from field to fork. So it means that we need the collaboration of customers, the collaboration even of consumers, e-commerce, and so I think it's a chapter that we will discover together. First of all, Barilla. Barilla, what is it? I think it's important, and I ask you to be some more patient to see with me this video that at least presents to you what we do and what we have still have been done in the last two centuries.
A future without pasta, a great loss for the world. For us, an unlikely forecast. For Barilla, everything begins with wheat, the pasta we make and have been making with passion for more than 135 years, contains the best grains grown in the same countries where the pasta is manufactured. We've always had a direct relationship with farmers, a choice that, over time, has allowed us to obtain the best raw materials. Pasta has been the queen of our products since 1877, when Pietro Barilla opened his shop in the center of Parma, where he also made bread. Over the years, we've added cookies, mini cakes, breadsticks, and pasta sauces. To keep up with modern times, we've also brought pasta as a ready meal to several countries. The Mediterranean diet is the lighthouse that guides our choices. Give people food that you would give your own children, said Pietro Barilla, the father of Guido, Luca, and Paolo, who currently run the company. Our industrial history began in 1910, when the first factory opened. And as far back as the 50s, we were already the market leader in Italy for pasta. In 1969, we built the Pedrignano plant in the outskirts of Parma. It's still the largest pasta factory in the world, with a capacity of 1,000 tons per day. In 75, the Mulino Bianco bakery line was launched, the Italian breakfast. Today, we can count on over 135 years of experience with 30 plants worldwide. We sell thousands of different products in over 100 countries. Our turnover is worth more than 3 billion euros. More than 8,000 people work for us, from Asia to the Americas. Nevertheless, our roots remain deeply Italian. We are a multinational company, but first of all, we are a family company, now in its fourth generation. While we respect stock markets, it's a world that doesn't belong to us. Our projects have broader horizons. Stock markets invest and disinvest too quickly. 360 degrees quality is our way of doing business, from seeds to crops, from developing new products to investing in the local territories we operate in. We want to help people, every single person, live better by bringing well-being and the joy of eating well into their everyday lives. We acknowledge diversity as an essential way to grow and enrich the company and its people. In 2009, we founded the Barilla Center for Food and Nutrition and came to the conclusion that real quality is obtained when the food we make is good both for people and for the planet. The Barilla Center's breakthrough was to put the traditional food pyramid next to the environmental pyramid, which illustrates the impact of food production and consumption on the environment. In a nutshell, fruits, vegetables, and cereal-based products such as pasta have the lowest impact on the environment. We are aware of the risks posed by climate change to wheat fields around the world, but we are well equipped to manage them. Rest assured, pasta will be around far beyond 2050. Good for you, good for the planet. That is our story. It's what we are, our philosophy, and our way of doing business for a brighter future.
So good for you, good for the planet is our long-term, brand. And it's a long heritage with what we do every day. My purpose now is to become more into the detail after I set these five typical strategic lines that we have. And you see the bold is the fourth. The fourth is really what is driving our research, our manufacturing, our collaboration with customers. We are selling the double pyramid, teaching also them into the school, starting to have these analogies between what is your choice as individual as a choice for better save the energy of this planet and save this for the generation to come. In effect, is important. As a food company, you may represent that 30% of food climate change, this is for Europe, but obviously is ready for anyone in this world, is made because of industry of food. So we, as a food player, we need to take this stake. How we are compelling this, we have already said this one. This one is it's really something that came from studies that have conglomerated experience. So Barilla have launched and found this big think tank, international think tank about food consumption, about culture of food, about accessibility to the food in different countries. I come to this conclusion. If you go to the, there's also a website, goodforyougoodfortheplanet.org, it's important that you can recap from an independent advisor point of view all this material, and I think it's even important that you can, as person, to spread this concept that are not Barilla only, but are recognized as a key factor for food manufacturing. Anyway, coming to more, to be more number-based. Number-based, the company, as you've seen, is in line with his budget and his, because we need to be also reliable from an economic point of view. We are not an ONG corporation, so we need to be efficient and effective in the market, selling in only one way to do business. And our product are the starting point. The starting point of our product is complex because it's not only pasta, as I said, or sauces, but we have a huge variety of products that are, some of them belonging to regional Europe, such as most of the bakery product you see here, but maybe some of the international attendees have recognized some of the brands that they maybe consume every day. And the product is a starting point because we start measuring from product what we say. For example, we have for each product we produce a real effective and recognized in terms of standard consumption of the resources. So we need to know where we affect more the consumption of ecological footprint in terms of carbon footprint and water footprint. This is the start base. I made the same some other conference, and I start anyone blame trucks, blame logistics, blame production. But when you come to food, from, as I said before, from farm to fork, you have to pay a lot of attention on the field. Here you see how the field is important in terms of consumption in raw material. And so that's why we started with our main partner in the supplying area, very important project quite worldwide, in order to have them along with us in this chain, in guaranteeing at the end this data, this visibility up to the consumer, in order to make the selection of our product not only a differentiation in cost and price, but also a differentiation in terms of quality, in terms of safety, in terms of healthiness, but also in terms of resource alignment. We hope it will be even more reinforced in the next slide, this message. And also in our operations, year by year, in our plants, in our logistic partner, and in our production certified by APD. APD is the international board that allows you to have this measurement about your processes to the product. So they get the product and they make back all the measure about sustainability. And our goal, you see, is very, in 2002, we need really to be even more effective. And it costs, but it's going to pay back a lot. Why is going to pay back a lot? Also because yesterday was presented by Accento what could be the next retailer, the next point of sale of the future. I wanted to recap that, because in Milan we have seen and we have participated with Coop in a very out of the box, but I think very real, shop of the future, where consumer could really appreciate by choice what is the difference between the different brands in terms of sustainability. Very shortly.
In the supermarket of the future at Expo Milano 2015, the shopper's experience is driven by the utmost transparency and accessibility thanks to multimedia technology. It makes active dialogue between producers, retailers, and shoppers possible, just like the dialogue between Barilla and its customers. This is why Barilla leads the cereal supply chain from field to fork. In the store of the future, shoppers can find a large assortment of all the most popular Barilla products. In the branded corner, multimedia installations provide information about Barilla traceability and sustainability programs with a special edition Fafale and Basilico sauce. Carboni's iconic design unveils a QR code which reveals where the products come from. That's how Barilla reveals the amazing story every product has to tell, in keeping with its good for you, good for the planet commitment.
So, having said that, what could be what has to be the supply chain behind this show? I think it's important to start from a very reliable point that is that has to be consistent. As always I say, the sequence is product, process, organization, and systems. The point is that sometimes people affected and are interested mostly and start from the system. The point is not there. So a system is a commodity. I think it's important to rely what is your product and then what are your processes. And then there is room for HR people to come in and help you to address even the organization that is really important in terms of people reaction and people capability. And systems, as you see, will have a grid part technology and system in order to allow you to have visibility and control. So supply chain in us is really more than the Barilla asset. So, as I said, from field to form, many of you have been exposed, I think, to this concept. But anyway, for us, planning, that is the key supply chain management tool and process, as a unique tower for all the business. And when I say a unique tower, it's not only in Parma, but it's spread in different organizations regarding the regional on the part. But the unique visibility and accountability stands in family of professional, where any kind of resource is visible and designed to the target of the to the consumer. It is important even the processes. The processes in our supply chain are those that you can see here. And the point is there is one only global chief. So it's important that sometimes if I have a project in bakery that is has some very good results, I have to spread it in pasta, regardless of the product. It's important that this, as Mondelez also, as a representative, it's important to have this global view because this kind of experience has to be benchmarked and has a value for the company as a whole. So the organization has to follow the processes. And the organization is this one is very important. The global accountabilities are unique. And then we have regional accountabilities, depending on the collection of plants and operation, in order to manage in respect of the guidelines from the corporate view and the alignment with a unique team that is this team. Any kind of supply chain region is really connected and cannot go selling a different balance between cost to serve and service level to the same client in different regions. So it's really important to have a unique consistency when you relate to the retailers. Integrated planning, again, just to say what is the backbone. The backbone is around 30 different manufacturing and mills that are mainly, as you see here, we have approached after Europe, US. US, when we started the business, we were 3% of the share. Now we are 36% of the share, and the second is 8%. The point is our business is really relevant when you have the scale to make a plant and be effective on a regional basis, because our products are poor, are not something that could be delivered and has to be very thin in the working capital in that. But you have to be very reliable and you have to know this network. Our people, when coming into supply chain, even if they are very good master in Fontainebleau or in MBA, they go for 1 year in a plant making shift leader. So is something that you can spend when you are young, because our plants are not really in the best location in the world, as always. And the point is, this experience made you very effective when you will be a decision making, because you know in your backbone how is affecting this decision to the real people. When I unbiased the forecast and I have to ask an external shift or an additional shift on Sunday, you know what is it in a plant to ask for in a relation of the union. So it's important that anyone in the chain is committed and well informed. Because our network in terms of distribution is complex. As I said, we want to maintain first of all, the capability to have our production is 96% internal. So, I mean, we don't opaque only some incremental innovation that we have, but 96% is made inside what we call made in Barilla system. And obviously, pasta is ambient, sauces are ambient. We can ship pasta and sauce whatever, wherever. Pasta and sauces together makes a very good chunk of our business, also because it's the most efficient way to sell and send carbohydrates along the globe. But here you see that managing these complex deliveries is really important, because sometimes the forecast for Australia conflict with the forecast with France, same product, same line, different product, so hours to be transformed in tons means that you have to decide if the stoccato will be in Australia or in France. And so the collaboration with client and the advanced customer forecast is very important. Again, I go very through. The really core is that one. So the sales and operational plan is the key process inside the company. I think sometimes it's really what is most of the differentiating factor for the success, at least for fast-moving consumer goods. I go very far on that because I think, given the audience, you know very well what is the thing. So planning is not a unique task. So sometimes someone says, I have made a plan for 1 year, I can have another job. No, planning is different quite every day, depending on what you are planning, what are the tasks that you can manage on that. But key is the customer collaboration in supply chain planning and data sharing that is main issue of that. So supply chain is managing of two things, physical transformation and distribution transformation, but management of data, because data is the feeding line for decisions. And it's important to have data in a structured way. For us, it's important for any country to fit this map together with sales in order to fit what is potential value for Barilla in conjunction with potential value for customers, strategic customers. And we, every year, revise this kind of metrics in order to assure my team that is customer service, connected with customer service within the supply chain, in order to get the real value for our client that is different in different countries. Obviously, we can talk about, as I proposed to you, VMI and OSA in such very developed situation. We have sometimes to design delivery model. For example, in China, we are designing delivery model with our client because we are approaching a new country. And important is, starting from very simple, we make more than 1 billion of the 3.5 that we do globally via VMI. VMI is the simplest way to decrease stocks. Stocks in the chain are of two things. One is functional, one is safety. And obviously, functional cycle stock are something that is given by the complexity, by the situation that you have, but safety stock is human-driven. And when you have in a chain more than one brain that decide and have accountability about safety stock, the point is the lower you have, the better it is. And in fact, we have from the client every day what they have out of their warehouses every day, and we deliver directly them on replenish these orders. It's typical in VMI system, but is decreasing a lot the cost associated. But we have more to do that I think on the shelf, because we as a brand, we are very interested that our products are on the shelf, because we are here at least at the warehouse. Then there is another supply chain to go from warehouse to the different point of sales. And the hand of our customer, of our client, consumer, is there and needs to be to found on the shelf the product. So we started some very good, I'm presenting here the one with Carrefour, but we made a tailored collaboration, because collaboration has to be tailored. And we've done with Carrefour a very good product, project in Italy that is exchange of, on a daily basis, a lot of data on our consumption of point of sales, hypermarket and supermarket. We crunch them with a key account management of OSHA, that is on-shelf availability, by the way. And through him, we give a lot of alert to our people on the field, Salesforce and our merchandise, that activate together with, in collaboration with the Carrefour people on the point of sales, that give feedbacks, and at the end, through a fishbone, why we stock out a point level and reconnect this kind of out of the stock, we can fulfill better, not only from plant and distribution center, but also to point of sales, our merchandise. This is a very helicopter overview. I will spend the next 5 minutes to present what is the chunk of data management inside, because there is a lot of data management, as you can see. And the point is that we have developed not the, we have developed our own solution, because we trust Nielsen data. I don't know if there is some Nielsen just for sales, but we want to have our accountability, because this is a logistic Trojan horse, but is a very big, good intelligence for sales. And having this crunch inside the company allows us to expect what is the sales for each point of sales attended in terms of promo, and what could be, and alert the people back. I think this, in a daily activity, starts very within every morning. Every morning someone open an OSA board and see the analytics, and the analytics are this one by day. And there is a critical list divided in promo and no promo items. Obviously, most of the problems are in promo items, as you can understand. This is something that is made by point of sales and then sent to each, in terms of collaboration, to each point of sales that is in the net. This activates a back office activity every day, where they receive, within the 2 o'clock, this list. They fill the root cause analysis. They have to say why, in their opinion or in their expertise, this has done this day at that point. And this is sent to a merchandiser, a barrel agent we pay for, that is going there to replenish and get out of the back office, of the shop sometimes, the merchandise in order to fill the shelves and let our client to come. And also, they have to go around the point of sales in order to see, in reality, if the systems has not detached other point of sales out of stocks. And it comes back, in terms of technology, back to the central tower, in order to reconnect this experience and making a knowledge management. So, in other words, barilla alerts give to the clients, daily execution in point of sales, feedback from POS, and structural analysis to get this as a cycle route in collaboration with clients. we started the project with Carrefour. Now the problem is Carrefour is asking us to do everywhere. And obviously you have to invest because this is carried out by one person, but you have to do it with other person. He's paying a lot because he's paying 3-4% of auto stocks. And it's a huge amount of money. And also is feeding back more, better, and accurate the intelligence of the market in terms of forecast. And is another good feedback for production and distribution. Finished. So that point, this is the last chart, is important that what I said, product sustainability data is relevant, and we want to be relevant because we are, as a company, in a good position, in a Mediterranean diet proposition, for consumer choice in food, and make it this data available to the consumer in the new technology world will be more differentiating the product of a producer that is capable to be consistent, coherent, even in the production. Total visibility and traceability are mandatory for today's consumer. So we are debating inside if doing even, obviously, the downstream traceability is easy. The upstream traceability, so knowing from each box who was the supplier, who was at that point, where the grain came from, is, in terms of system, a bit more difficult, but I think we are going to do it because it's mandatory. Sales and planning integrated process, so together, sales with their accountability, but planning and customer service integrated with supply chain are key. And as I say, farmer, producer and retail collaboration makes all of this chain affordable and consistent and allow you to have the better performance and reliability of the supply chain. I think I finished. There is point questions. I'm here.
Any questions?
Hi, Stefano. Let's talk about Barilla in China here. With the emerging markets such as e-commerce here, I would assume Barilla product are imported overseas, correct? And then I would like to know, because you know the spike market, you know, like e-commerce, I don't know how this is going to adapt different strategy from the supply chain perspective here. Let me elaborate the reason why I ask, because I know Barilla used to have only two distributors in China, one in Shanghai, one in Beijing, and then about 2 years ago, you had a different strategy, you wanted to take control on your own, imported from Tianjin, Shanghai, and Shenzhen. So would the strategy be different, and then how to implement here? Thank you.
Very good. You are very well informed. I like it very much. So anyway, as I have seen in the previous speech, it's important to see e-commerce to be integrated because as you have some peculiarity in e-commerce that are mainly for emerging market when you have in the lucky position to start from scratch. So we don't have to pay any token back to the retailer that we have already in Europe where they see maybe a direct e-commerce as a concurrent way to deliver the same product, so another shelf to compete with their shelf. Here in China, I think it's really important to leverage the capability that we have already offline, and we want to increase offline on urbanized areas, also with the capability that we can integrate with e-commerce. So knowing that e-commerce here has at least some very good efficiencies in terms of deliveries. But when we make e-commerce, we want also to manage together with the e-commerce partner the content of the product. And the content of the product means sometimes also to have access to crowding, access to social media in order to, and we have, I think, a very, very good developed area in that in order to sell the story around the product and have the unique possibility to have a free discussion about it. I know that this is a problem that is going to be solved, yes, I think, in any way. But we think that in this country, e-commerce will play a tremendous effort and a tremendous powerful opportunity for us.
Yeah, I was impressed by what you've done on sustainability and also the transparency of sustainability data to your consumers. Did you measure, have you been able to measure how impactful it is for your consumers, especially the first moment of choice? I mean, the act of buying your product, is that really impacting? Because in the past, we've seen that it may impact some consumers in Germany, for instance, who are very sensitive. But in other countries, the consumer did not really care. So that's why I'm interested with this, whether you've been able to measure the impact.
Is it true? The response and the sensibility is different, given the Maslow scale of that is something that is in the human being. But the point is that we are measuring the effect of the change when we claim this, and we are affecting on that, not only on these kind of things that I presented to you, but imagine, for example, we launch a state-of-the-art new plant for sauces. And we have chosen, with a very long debate, internal debate, to put on the internet a website that is called Guarda tu stesso, Look by Yourself, where a consumer can go into, like a Google car, could go along the whole plant and see the production when you do it. Imagine from, I'm also responsible to the discussion with engineering and so, but it pays, in terms of clicks, repetitive clicks and buying, it's really part, I think, a 30% of the success that this plant that we launched 2 years ago is already now out of capacity. And I think, especially in Europe, it is very potential. Not to say about what we have done in the Nordic countries, they're really sensible of that, in Vasa product and so on. But when you are consistent, first of all, it has to be measured, as you said. Measure on product, measure on consumer. But the effects of these multiple wording, password, that's what I was saying before. It's important when you make it viral in some way. And this kind of effects are incommensurable. If you go to the net, you see www, guarda tu stesso, you can catch.
Okay, thank you, Stefano. And we can move to next panel discussion.